I think the most beautiful award I got today was a beautiful hug from Razdeep. And the moment he said, Anshu, I love you. I said, boss, you know, the day is made. So, you know, between two humor, Razdeep and Razdeep, I don't know how these organizers have sandwiched me, who will only talk about, you know, some really, really terrible stories and disturbing stories, because we all know the realities are always disturbing. So my next 15 minutes are here to disturb, for sure. I'm not at all a pessimist. Bahut optimism hai, there's a huge amount of optimism, that's why all of us are working. But it's extremely important for all of us to understand certain realities. And you know, when I speak about the disability, very small incident in my personal life where I saw it very closely because I was admitted in government hospital thrice in a year. I remained on bed for about 1 year. 1987, met with a massive accident in Dehradun and was admitted in a government hospital. As I said, remained there for a year. And I had to be operated. And in those days, in the country where bribe is so common, the minimum rate to do an operation in a government hospital in Dehradun was 400 rupees. So if you do not give 400 rupees, next day the operation will not happen, or the doctors will trouble you. Same happened in my family. We never speak about bribe at all. It's not a part of our life. It didn't reach. Morning, the shameless doctor actually asked. My proud father, my mom, said it will not happen. And I still remember, you know, those few words of the doctor, where he said, ki yadi ye ladka mar gaya, to kya karenge? Imagine the guy who is going to operate you is actually saying that if this kid dies, what will he do? And my proud parents actually said, ki fir wo hamari luck hai, then it's our luck. Somehow, whatever happened in the name of operation, the fact remains that I remain in pain 24 hours. It is a distorted foot, whatever way. But you know, I never knew in my life that I will actually get into the hardcore job of logistics in our life, which is equal to bribe. But whenever it pains a lot, I always, you know, thank my parents who are no more. And I always say that if my parents would have bribed, would have given those 400 rupees that day, I would have been standing on the bribed foot. Today I stand on my own foot. That's a huge... So my next few minutes are just the stories of the non-issues. In this country, when we talk about disability, I often ask people that this is a country where we do not value the common citizen. The citizen with two hands, two legs, eyes, you know, as we all call ourselves. This country does not value its common citizen. How do you even imagine that people will really, really value people with any kind of disability? That mindset has to be challenged, for sure. We just need to raise voice against all these kind of discrimination. And it is not about only the government and corrupt systems and all that. It is about the aam janta, you know what Razdeep has just shared. It is also because maybe as a nation, we are not able to understand the issues and we are just running in the rat race of whatever comes from outside. Some of the very simple issues in the next 10, 12 minutes I'll share with you. And you know, and that's how you'll see what I'm trying to say. Yesterday only from the same stage, I was asking people that today if you go to a private school in India, which unfortunately, you know, in India we call public schools, every third, fourth kid you see wearing glasses, spectacles. If you see, if you go to a government school, a municipality school, you hardly see any kid wearing glasses. So my question is that education hampers because teacher-student ratio is wrong or education policy is wrong, or education also happens because the kid cannot see. In the last 18 years of our work at Goonj, we have never seen any truck driver wearing glasses. Dust, heat, whatever. So the accidents are happening because the dog comes on the road, or accidents are also happening because the driver cannot see. So you know what I'm trying to say? That whole lot of us who are in the decision making or in the doing part or in the supporting part are actually not able to see these so-called non-issues. 1998, we started something called Goonj on a very basic non-issue. We said that you talk about three basic needs. You say roti, kapda aur makan, food, cloth, and shelter. Cloth, you remember, when a disaster happens. So you need a flood to be flooded with clothes. Cloth, you remember, when you want to do some charity. We said, how come earthquake, you know, earthquake is a disaster, flood is a disaster. How come winters are not a disaster? Why don't we have figures of people who die or suffer due to lack of clothing in winters? 1991, I was doing my journalism, roaming around on the roads of Old Delhi, suddenly saw this rickshaw. It says, Lavaris Lash Uthane Wala, which means a person who picks up unclaimed, abandoned dead bodies. Strange profession for a new budding journalist, and especially in those ethical days of journalism, you really used to work a lot on these kind of stories. I spent about a week with these people on the footpath, early morning used to go, outside LNJP hospital in Delhi they used to stay. Habib Bhai and his blind wife, Amna Begum. Full-time job, pick up dead bodies of, you know, people, migrated people. Every day, these people used to pick up 10 to 12 dead bodies from the range of 4 to 5 kilometers where they were able to take the rickshaw. In the summers, the average used to be 4 to 5. Habib's daughter, that's my daughter, almost of the same age, called Bano, who actually gave the most shocking statement in Hindi. She said, ki jab mujhe thand lagti hai, to main lash ke saath chipak kar so jaati hu. She further says, lash tang nahi karti, lash karvat nahi badalti. When I feel cold, I hug the dead body and sleep. It does not trouble me, it does not turn around. A few kilometers away from her, people like us stay. Our wardrobes are full, waiting for a disaster to give it away. But just because we never understood that clothing is also an issue, and winters are also a disaster. We started working with about 67 personal clothes, two agendas. A, we will reposition it, make it an issue. So the moment an urban person will say that I'm donating cloth, we'll say that, listen, you actually do not donate, you discard. You give 1,000 rupees to someone, you can call it a donation. But something which I've already used for 1 year or 2, it is actually not a donation, it's a discard. The only beautiful word which you can use is that I want to give clothes. On the other hand, the material goes to rural India. One thing which we understood about rural India is that the biggest asset of rural people is their self-respect, is their dignity. You do not find beggars in the villages. Begging is a city phenomena. That's where this beautiful, you know, that's where this beautiful concept came up. It's called cloth for work. So, you know, many people, even in the crowd, because we have a Bangalore office and a lot of people are associated with Goonj in a big way. And a whole lot of us, you know, think that we actually collect and distribute material. That's the only thing which we don't do. So we deal with 3,000 tons of material, but it has become a currency for us for development, cross-sector. So some of the pictures I'll just run through so that you understand what are we trying to do. Cloth for Work means, it's a symbolic name, where people take up their own issues, where no one is, you know, sitting in the center or in the state or NGO or CSR is telling them that this is the work you have to do. They decide on their own issues, work on that. Instead of money, they earn in cloth, utensil, footwear, all kind of second-hand material. Just to show you some pictures. This is how the ponds are revived. Absolutely local resources. If you see this last picture, you see a sari there. You see a tube, you see a buffalo. Local resources, local wisdom, local work, and local solution. Reward, your second-hand material, duly sorted, neatly done, and then it is given as a family pack. Roads in the difficult terrain, see what people have made. No machine, no engineer, no JCB. Just the local hard work. Wells. So in a year, we are actually doing some 1,500, 2,000 such huge activities where the currency is your material. So if you see in this model, people in the last picture are actually paying back in a currency called labor. We pay them in a per currency called material. Money, which is about 15 crore annual budget of Goonj, is for the logistics of it, because we are about 600 people and we work in 22 states. So in a way, it is the genesis of a parallel economy, which is not cash-based, but trash-based. Also, we have been able to identify two new currencies. So it is actually a barter between labor and material. The two new currencies, and money is for the logistics of this. Mangroves, Dal Lake, some 1 lakh square meter. This is how the disaster work happens. This is where in school, you know, it becomes a currency, it becomes a motivation for change. So instead of giving it as charity, this is how the kids receive it. We work on the etiquette and behavior of the kids and then give it. My important issue for today. When we were working on cloth in 2004-05, we raised a very basic issue. We said that every single woman across the globe needs a piece of cloth, which is now called sanitary pad. Very taboo issue. We don't want to talk about it. Even you buy the best quality product from the market, the ultra-thin sanitary pad, it is always wrapped in a black polythene or in a newspaper. We said that if you do not have enough to wear, from where and how you bring this piece of cloth. In any case, the rural community, the so-called poor communities across the country, survive on the synthetic or nylon cloth. For this purpose, you need a cotton cloth. Cotton cloth I can afford, you can afford, many of us can afford, not the so-called financially poor people. 2004-05, and it is really, really alarming, and that's why I'm saying, you know, non-issue, and in a minute I'll actually also talk about this particular issue related to the disability, you know, groups. So we just went on Google, typed sanitary pad, sanitary napkin, because we wanted to understand the subject. You type sanitary pad, sanitary napkin, all the synonyms. Best possible tampons and cups from all across the globe will be visible. Not even a single major research in India, no problem, no solution. Extremely shocking for us. We started traveling across the country and we found out. They use the dirtiest piece of cloth because for them it's a synonym of dirt. They wash it, they cannot dry it in sunlight because the kind of clusters people live. Washing is a problem because life depends on public taps. Public taps, in the name of public convenience, are always put up at a public place. Millions and millions of women and the girls are actually using sand, ash, jute bags, rugs, racks, newspapers, dry grass, plastic sheet, used sanitary pad to cow dung. Anything and everything which can stop, which can absorb, is used as a sanitary pad. We have cases where a lady used a piece of blouse which had a hook, she died of tetanus. A case came up in Chennai where a centipede entered and the lady died. How many of us working in the sector have ever thought about this particular thing? The blind people, we have experienced a lot, you know, in this particular, I mean, that's the, to be honest, that's one very valuable experience we have in this particular sector. The blind girl knows blood is red, but she has never seen red. She does not even know that she's down. The person who crawls, goes to the washroom, in that situation where she does not have anything to change. People without hands don't know how to change. And they cannot change. I can go on hundreds of such realities in whatever research we have done, but the fact remains that all of you sitting here are much, much more experienced in this particular sector than us. Please understand these non-issues. What is visible is not the only thing. You know, in my lectures, there is a phrase which I always say, look beyond, see invisible. One problem I've just raised today, humble request from all of you, whatever way you are dealing with disability, we are small people, we can only come and share our learning, but the fact remains that you all can become a big learning ground for us. The time has come that we also start talking about certain issues which otherwise are very taboo issues. Just giving a wheelchair is not enough. We have seen Anandwan, which is the temple, you know, for different kind of disabilities, and where when there 400 strong band of disabled people, which is a very beautiful band they have, you know, the orchestra, when they travel in the buses, the biggest problem for the band is the public toilets. Bus travels, where are the public toilets? And if there are public toilets, where is the access for the wheelchairs? If the boy can go somehow, how will the girl go? So maybe, you know, in the next summit or before that, we all will discuss about it. Today we have just raised this issue, and we are very serious to work on it. We have come out with a very simple solution in the terms of cloth. It's a reusable, recyclable, but the fact remains that we are very small in terms of, you know, we have done few million pads, and million is not a big number in India in any case. So most important for us is to open up this issue. Remove the culture of shame and silence. Use this piece of cloth or any other sanitary pad as a tool so that we start a dialogue. This is where a lot of people with different kind of, you know, I should not say disability, because we have never experienced that disability. Even our workshop is headed by a person who does not have a leg, and we make the most beautiful product. In fact, the bag which you are holding in your hand, that is created by that group only. All the products, many of our team members, you know, they do it, and we have never experienced that. Our rickshaw, you know, the thela for local transport is actually done by a person who does not have a hand. So before they kick me out, let me just show you these last three pictures, because these are important pictures. Just 1 minute, sorry. So I just want your reactions on, you know, on this particular picture. It's a very visible face everywhere in the country and across, in the books, outside railway stations. You know, the shakal, the, you know, the face might be different, but you see these kids. So I'm just asking you, when you see this kid, what is that first word, thought, sentence comes in your mind? This is something I'm doing for the last 15 years, and many of our team members doing the same exercise, just to showcase that how the perception changes, how a lot of big problems have small solutions. Please react. What is the first word, sentence, thought comes in your mind? Cloth, what else? I relate hunger to this kid, suppose. Cold, pity, afraid, anything. All of us are very sensitive people. We might not be able to help every single kid like this, but we will, you know, experience, we'll feel something. What is that first word, sentence comes in your mind? Sad, basically. So in a way, this is what I said yesterday also, that if I leave you, you know, maybe for 5 minutes with this picture or 2 minutes for this picture, every single negative word in your vocabulary will come out. What do you say? Naked, pity, bechara, lachar, bhuka, nanga. A piece of cloth changes. A piece of cloth, which is so important for me, how come that piece of cloth is not important for every single person with whom we work, we live, we see? And cloth is also about, look at this. You will call him sharabi, nashadi, all kind of negative things. And that's where you see a powerful youth. And the fact remains that, you know, I was having coffee, and if I would have poured 2 drops or maybe, a sip of coffee here, you think I would have been talking with the same confidence? If I lose my confidence with a spot on my cloth, what about the confidence of millions and millions of people without a piece of cloth? In the last picture, don't you think that it is much easier for us to take the second kid to the school than the first kid? The third generation. So you don't even talk about this person when you go to the village, and if I ask you that you have to stay with this person, have a cup of tea, have food, how many of us honestly will actually do that? And suddenly you call him Kaka. So my only thing is, you know, the time has come that we start understanding that it's not our right to live and other people survive. If we want equality, if we want justice, if we want this nation to really, really become beautiful, it's extremely important that we give the same right to every single person. It's also extremely important that we start looking at these non-issues, which are not popular, which will never have money from people. It will take its own time, but these are needed. Thank you very much. This is what we're trying to do.
Thank you, Anshuji. And I had done research and mujhe pata chala aap achhi kavita bhi likh lete, kuch chand shabd kahenge sir aap. You write very good poetry, right? Just two, three stanzas. My research says that, so I think so you should be able to. Bol dijiye.
Achha, toh main is wale halat ke liye, matlab jo hai, hum log jo hai, uske liye bolta hun.
Okay, bolie.
Ek maine likha tha ki, agar neend se pyara hai sapna, aur zid ke saath le sakte ho jokhim, to ye jagah tumhari hai. Agar bhook lage, aur yaad aaye bhookha, aur pyaas par talab ek sookha, to ye jagah tumhari hai. Agar nahi chahte aag lagana, aur chingari hai ek maksad, to ye jagah tumhari hai. Aur mera last stanza yahan ke doston ke liye, to bahut lambi hai, main ek aaj short karke. Agar aankh nahi par drishti hai, tan ka ek bhag nahi par masti hai, to ye jagah tumhari hai.